myself, I'm not going to be grading for transfers, which I said in that video. So if you want to hear my grades for the likes of Erling Haaland and Darwin Nunez and many other players, make sure you check out that video. There will be a link in the description for it. But yeah, we're going to be doing the same thing today. We're also going to be looking at some of Europe's biggest transfers, giving them a grade out of 10, 10 being the highest, obviously based on their price, their age, you know, all that sort of stuff. Now, I'm not going to grade every single Prem one. I will tell you which ones have happened, but because there have been so many, this video will be way too long. So I'm going to grade the big ones and then system. He's obviously worked with Arteta before, so Arteta knows him very well, and I think he can do that link-up play which they needed from a striker, but he can also score goals, and I'm going to be very interested to see what he can do leading the line, and he can also play on the right wing, so it's very versatile. Signing, I'm gonna give it a 9 out of 10 to be honest. Aston Villa have not signed anyone since we last spoke. Bournemouth have signed Ryan Fredericks from West Ham and Joe Rothwell from Blackburn on free transfers. I won't grade them, but just to let you know. Brentford, oh yeah, also some of these I'm also including ones which are really close as of right now, so if they do not happen, then just forget what I'm saying. But, for example, Brentford, it looks as though they're about to sign Aaron Hickey and Keane Lewis Potter. I'll do a little grade for these quickly. Aaron Hickey, I have heard a lot of good things about him. Apparently he is like really good. He's a young left wing back from Scotland playing in Bologna, apparently really good on both feet, and I was very surprised Brentford have managed to get him, because I saw him linked to many other clubs, so I will give this a good grade of 9 as well. Keane Lewis Potter, good young player out of the Championship, will be interesting to see what he's doing in the Prem. Bit of a hefty fever, around 15 million I believe, so I'll give that a 7. Someone who can score minimum 15 league goals in a campaign. shown he can do that, so I believe it's a good signing. He should be able to slot in to that front three fairly easily and provide some goals. So I will give that I'll give it a 9, to be honest. I'll give it a 9. Crystal Palace look like they've signed, as of recording, check signed fairly young, could develop into a good left back. Obviously, Ten Hag knows about him a lot because he would have seen him in the Eredivisie. Apparently, he tried to sign him actually for Ajax, so he could prove out to be good competition or even the starting left back for Man U. Give it a 7. Newcastle have signed Nick Pope, since we last spoke. Very good signing, very, very cheap. And yeah, fantastic. Give that a 9 out of 10. I believe it's only like 5 million. Oh, no, 10 million. We've also signed Sven Botman, which I was really impressed about. Again, I thought Botman could have gone to bigger, better clubs, but they've done fantastic for Newcastle. Very, very highly rated out of Lille, and he's a huge upgrade on their centre backs. They needed new centre backs, so he's a big upgrade. I'll give it an 8 out of 10. And I have also just realised I forgot to mention that Eriksen looks like he is about to sign for Manchester United. I'll quickly grade that. Free transfer, absolutely fantastic. No risk at all because you ain't paying a transfer. Great backup for Bruno Fernandes. They needed another midfielder who they can bring on. Give it a 9 out of 10. Nottingham Forest, since we last spoke, signed Taiwo Awoniyi, Julian Bianconi, and Musa Niakata, but I don't really know anything about those guys. We won't rate them. Southampton have signed Matthias Liz, Omar Bilicic, and Romeo Lavia, and also Joe Aribo looks like they're coming in. I do know a bit about Joe Aribo from the Europa League, but not going to give that a rating. Spurs have signed Richarlison since we last spoke. Now this one's interesting. To be honest, personally, I think it's a bit of a weird one. They've spent like, what is it, 60 to 70 million on Richarlison here. I think Richarlison's a very good player. I think he's done well for Everton. He basically kept them up last season. But I just think it's weird to spend that much money on somebody who, Richarlison's best position is striker or left wing. And they've got Gainers on. So is he really going to play ahead of them? Probably not. You're going to have to push him out right wing, which is just not his natural position. He might be good there, but if you're not going to play him right wing, then you've paid all that money for a bench player, which is a bit weird in my opinion. But nevertheless, I think he's a very good player. I just think it's a bit weird, so I will go for a 5. West Ham, we've spoke about all their signings before. And Wolves have not signed anyone. Now we will quickly dip into some of the big transfers across Europe. So, Dortmund have been very active. They've signed Karim Adeyemi from Red Bull Salzburg. Fantastic signing. He's very young. He's 20 years old striker. I remember he's done really well in the Champions League this season. Scored lots of goals in the group stage, really impressed me. Give it a 9 out of 10. They also signed Sebastian Haller from Ajax, another striker who's done well in the Champions League this season. Looks like they signed two to replace Haaland, and I think he could do well. He's proven himself in the Bundesliga to be very well capable of doing well, as seen with Frankfurt. And he's just had a fantastic year with Ajax. I'll give it a 7 out of 10. Speaking of Ajax, they look like they're about to sign Steven Bergwijn. Like this signing I do. He's 24 years old. He's had a tough time at Spurs. He's had glimpses of promise. He's done well, but he never really established himself a starting spot. And I think at Ajax it's a fresh start. He's proven himself in the Eredivisie before, so I think he can really take his career back to the top level at Ajax. I'll give it a 6 out of 10 because they did pay quite a hefty fee. like both of these deals. I think they are very good players. Christiansen, good player. I think he can slot in very well in Barcelona's system at the centre back position. They needed a partner for Ronaldo Araujo, in the long term, and I believe Christiansen is that. I'll give him an 8 out of 10 because they haven't paid anything as well. Kessie, system, they've got a lot of midfielders in there, and he's not really that lone DM, so it would be interesting to see how much he plays, but they're going for 3, so I'll give it a 6. Another player who moved for 3 is Antonio Rudiger to Real Madrid. Absolutely amazing, to be honest. I'll give it a 9 out of 10. I was considering a 10 out of 10, but he is on very hefty wages, I do believe, so that is going to drag it down a level. Is one of the best centre backs in the world. However, it's a bit weird because they have got Alaba and Militao, who literally just won the Champions League for them. So, are they going to drop them, or is Alaba going to move like left back? Could be interesting to see what happens there. Another player who went for 3 is Paul Pogba. It looks like he has gone to Juventus, and also Di Maria has joined Juventus on a 3 as well. Signing from Juventus's perspective. From his perspective, I believe that he probably could have gone somewhere else. It is a little bit of a boring move, but it's still a fantastic business from Juventus. Di Maria, again, decent. He is fairly old now, but he's still at the top of his game. I believe it's only like 2 years as well, which is good. Consider subscribing, and I will see you in another one.